Welcome. Welcome
to the Michael Smirkanish Program.
Hey, gang, thanks so much for being here. It was 30 years ago tonight that I marked the beginning of my career in talk radio.
Well, I don't know why I came here tonight. I got the feeling there's something right.
I met Ronald Reagan. I twice interviewed President Barack Obama. I drank champagne from the Stanley Cup. I had a seven-hour dinner with Fidel Castro at his house.
Clowns to the left of me, jokers to the right. Stuck in the middle with you.
Of course I talk for a living. It's always been my calling. And not because I'm a lawyer, not because I have a background in politics.
In retrospect, I guess I just wanted the attention. I host a daily radio program that bears my name. I have a weekly cable television program, and I've authored 7 books. I'm pleased with those achievements, but I am far more proud of what went into them. Well, you know what they say about the best laid plans, right? Welcome to the show I was about to take out on the road before the pandemic hit. As you watch, ask yourself, which changed more in the last 30 years, the country or me? I turned 18 and registered to vote. That spring, my father decides to make a run for public office. My first time as a voter, I got to vote for my dad. I was hooked on politics. I was given a guest host gig, and soon I was offered many of the most unpopular fill-in times, Thanksgiving night, Super Bowl Sunday, I did them all. But I was now being paid for something that I would gladly have done for free.
Hey, Governor, we wish you Godspeed tonight.
Thank you, buddy. A lot of it's going to come down to the great state of Pennsylvania, and that's why I'm calling, Michael.
Of course I've changed in the last 30 years. I think we all have, right? What's different is that, in my case, all of my opinions have been captured on audio and videotape. Philadelphia Magazine, April issue 2009. What the hell was I thinking? I've moved from a reliably Republican voter to a registered independent. I would argue that the Republican Party today doesn't resemble the GOP that I joined in 1980. Gridlock is what you get when Washington takes its cues from those with microphones and not the vast majority of the people.